In this video, you'll see some additional editing plane enhancements. The functionality of the Pickplane command has been enhanced. When not creating or editing elements, you can select a surface to set its plane as the editing plane, or define it using the other possible methods, such as by 3 points or by point and edge. During input and editing, if you use the Pickplane command, the resulting editing plane will be parallel to the plane you click and will go through the edit origin. So in effect, the plane of the clicked surface is taken and then offset in the same step so that it goes through the edit origin. The horizontal and vertical editing plane selection commands are also available in selection mode as well. When creating or editing elements, the horizontal and vertical commands may also be used to switch to the desired editing plane. The offset command also has a new functionality. When you offset the editing plane in selection mode, the user origin moves with it, so it's always on the editing plane. The relocation of the user origin changes the default elevation for all element types. So to place a construction element in 3D at a certain height, you don't have to modify its default elevation value, but can instead graphically offset the editing plane or relocate the user origin by using the Alt plus Shift keys, and that will change the elevation value automatically. Then you can place the element, after which you can even reset the location of the user origin. Another new command, named Return to Last Editing Plane, is also available. When the editing plane is redefined during element creation or editing, you can return to the default editing plane. Then, with the editing plane at its default position, you can use this command to switch back to the last defined editing plane. So using these commands, you can toggle between the last redefined editing plane and the default editing plane.